This hasn't changed at all in 3 years.
Did I scare you?
Yeah, you did. I guess I deserved it, huh? The fart face that I am.
Maybe. Then again, maybe you're not so bad. Just annoying.
Uh-huh. So, you got any other things planned? I think I saw a dark room back there you could lock me up in.
No. I think you've had enough. For now.
Well, that's reassuring.
Besides, I need your help finding Mary. She's here. Isn't she? Come on, tell me.
I wish I knew.
But she said it in her letter.
Wait. So there really is a letter?
Oh. Yeah. Wanna read it? Just don't tell Rachel, okay?
Who's Rachel?
She's our nurse. I, took it from her locker.
My dearest Laura, I'm leaving this letter with Rachel to give to you after I'm gone. I'm far away now, in a quiet, beautiful place. Please forgive me for not saying goodbye before I left. Be well, Laura. Don't be too hard on the sisters. And Laura, about James. I know you hate him because you think he isn't nice to me, but please, give him a chance. It's true, he can be a little surly sometimes, and he doesn't laugh much. But underneath, he's a really sweet person. I love you, Laura. I love you like my very own daughter. I wish things were different. I wish we could be happy together, like we talked about. Even so, I know you will have a good life. You're a strong, smart, beautiful girl. Happy 8th birthday, Laura. Your friend, Mary.
Laura, how old are you?
I turned 8 last week.
Does that mean Mary couldn't have died 3 years ago? Could she really be here? Is this the quiet, beautiful place she was talking about?
Me and Mary talked a lot about Silent Hill. She even showed me all her pictures. She really wanted to come back. She also talked a lot about you, you know? She even...
What? What is it?
Well, there kind of was this other letter. I think the one was for you. The envelope had your name on it.
Did you read it?
I wanted to. This one time, I almost did. Figured you didn't deserve to have it. But then I thought, Mary wouldn't want me to keep it from you. So I just sort of kept it for you. Here.
It's empty. Laura, there's nothing in it.
What? But I didn't take it. I swear.
Well, where is it then?
I must have lost it. I gotta find it.
Laura! Laura.
It's gotta be somewhere.
James.
God damn it.
Thank you. Are you taping again? Come on. I don't know why, but I just love it here. It's so peaceful. You know what I heard? This whole area used to be a sacred place. I think I can see why. It's too bad we have to leave. Promise you'll take me again, James.
Do you know where Mary is? Come on, talk to me.
Mary's gone. She's dead.
Liar. That's a lie.
No. It's the truth.
She died because she was sick.
I killed her.
Killer? Why'd you do it? I hate you. I want her back. Give her back to me. I knew it. You didn't care about her. I hate you, James! I hate you! I hate you! I hate you! She was always waiting for you. Why? Why?
I'm sorry. Mary, you know, isn't here. Mary?
James! Where are you? I'm waiting. I'm waiting for you. Please, come to me. Do you hate me? Please, why won't you come?
But where? Where are you?
Mama? Mama! I was looking for you. You're the only one left. Maybe then I can finally rest. Mama. What's wrong? Wait. You're not my mama. It's you.
Sorry, Angela. I think you were right. What we're looking for is not here. Not anymore.
Thank you for helping me earlier. But I wish you hadn't. Even Mama said it. I deserve what happened.
No, Angela, that is not true.
Don't pity me. I'm not worth it. Or maybe you think you can save me? Will you love me? Care for me? Heal all my pain? That's what I thought. James. Give me back the knife.
No, I won't.
Saving it for yourself. Have it your way. It doesn't change anything. Too. For me, it's always like this.
James!
Leave her alone! Leave us both the hell alone! I know what you are. I know why I needed you. But it's all over now. I don't need you anymore.
What do you want, James?
Flowers? I don't want any damn flowers. Just go home already. Look at me. I'm disgusting. Between the disease and the drugs, I look like a monster. Well, what are you looking at? Get the hell out of here. Leave me alone already. I'm no use to anyone. I'll be dead soon anyway. It'd be easier if they just killed me. But I guess the hospital's making a nice profit off of me. Why are you still here? I told you to go. Are you deaf?
Mary? I have missed you so much.
I've missed you too. We can finally be together. Forever.
No.
James. Honey. What's wrong?
I'm sorry. I know you tried.
James, please.
But she's gone. I know that now.
Stop it.
And I can't just keep pretending.
Shut up! What do you want? Do you even know anymore? I'm yours. I'm here for you. So what if I'm not her? can give you what she never could, I can be better than her. What else do you want me to be? What else can I be?
I am so sorry, Maria. I really am. But this has to stop. It's time to let it go.
No.
What?
I won't let you do this to me. I won't let you go. I can't!
Thank you.
Hey, handsome.
Sorry.
Don't be. I told you. I wanted the pain to end.
Yeah. You did. But that's not why I did it. The truth is, I hated you. I wanted you out of the way. I wanted my life back.
If that's true, then why do you look so sad?
Mary.
It's okay, James. Here.
What is this?
It's what you've been looking for. In my restless dreams, I see that town. Silent Hill. You promised you'd take me there again someday. But you never did. Well, I'm alone there now. In our special place. Waiting for you to come and see me. But you never do. So, I wait, wrapped in my cocoon of pain and loneliness. I know, I've done a terrible thing to you. I wish I could change that, but I can't. I feel so pathetic and ugly laying here. Every day I stare up at the cracks in the ceiling, and all I can think about is how unfair it is. The doctor came today. Told me I could go home for a short stay. It's not that I'm getting better. It's just that this could be my last chance. Even so, I'm glad to be coming home. I missed you so much. But I'm afraid, James. I'm afraid you don't really want me to come home. Every time you come to see me, I can tell how hard it is on you. I don't know if you hate me or pity me. Maybe I just disgust you. I'm so sorry. When I first learned I was gonna die, I couldn't accept it. I was so angry. I struck out at everyone I loved. Especially you. And that's why I understand if you hate me. But I want you to know, I will always love you. Even though our life together had to end like this, I still wouldn't trade it for the world. Well, this letter has gone on too long, so I'll say goodbye. I told the nurse to give this to you after I'm gone. Which means that as you're reading this, I'm already dead. But that's okay. I'm not afraid of it anymore. I just hope the pain will end soon. So that you remember me for who I was. And not what the disease made me. I want you to go on. I want you to live. For yourself. And for others. Like you did for me. James. You made me happy.